Hacking is not that easy. Some says it's even very difficult. But here is a cheap device that makes it all much, much easier. And meet Pwnagotchi, your cute digital pet that eats Wi-Fi. And Pwnagotchi is an open source, budget-friendly device based on a Raspberry Pi 0W designed for hacking Wi-Fi networks. Carry it around, feed it with Wi-Fi, and watch its AI evolve. In simple words, the more Wi-Fi handshake he gets, the happier he is. Now, this Raspberry Pi uses an e-ink display and some clever software with even cool plugins that we'll speak later, and I will leave a link. But it also has some twist. First, leave him without food too long and he will actually get angry with you. The second thing is that he actually ran on artificial intelligence. So over time, Pwnagotchi will learn to capture Wi-Fi handshakes better and tune his own parameters. Now, I know it's all sound weird or odd, but this is why I made this video to explain further. So without further ado, let's start. So first thing first, the assembly, and putting together a hacker toolkit isn't as hard as it sounds. First off, snag a Raspberry Pi 0W, like I show here, and you can find it around $24 online. And this is the brain of the operation. Power it up with any power supplies. The one I found is $33, but definitely they are much cheaper. And if you want to see your Pwnagotchi smiling as well, I'm sure you do, right? Add this e-ink display for about $20. Now, last but not least, don't forget a micro SD card for the operating system. 8 GB is enough. I found here 16 GB at around $7. It does the trick. So the total hardware cost, it's $84 for me, but with a little digging, you might just whip it up under the $50. Cool, right? So when the hardware is assembled, we need to download the firmware from Pwnagotchi project website and write to the SD card using a Balina Etcher program. Once the firmware is written on the micro SD card, we access it on the computer. This is important. Now open the boot folder and create a config file called config.toml. In this file, we will need to specify the virtual pet's name, screen type, and names of our home Wi-Fi network. Otherwise, Pwnagotchi will hack them, so be careful. And once ready, connect the Pwnagotchi to computer and configure IP address and gateway for the SSH access to the device. Now power up the device and it will work automatically. Super simple and easy. And definitely I will leave a lot of information in the description and links with README files so you can follow and do it by yourself. Now to grasp why an NI craving handshakes is valuable, let's delve into the Wi-Fi handshake 101. So when your device, like your phone connecting to home Wi-Fi, aims to securely transmit and receive data, it undergoes a crucial process, the four-way handshake, in the WPA-WPA2 wireless protocol. This handshake involves the exchange of four packets between your device and the access point, leading to the generation of WPA encryption keys derived from the access point's Wi-Fi password. Once this exchange is successful, your device is authenticated, allowing secure transmission and reception of data packets to and from the wireless access point. So what's the catch, you may ask, right? So well, these four packets can easily be sniffed by an attacker monitoring nearby, say with a Pwnagotchi. And once recorded, that attacker can use dictionary and or brute force attacks to crack the handshakes and recover the original Wi-Fi key. In fact, successful recovery of the Wi-Fi key doesn't necessarily even need all four packets, to be honest. A half handshake containing only two of the four packets can be cracked too, and in some or most cases, just a single packet is enough even without clients. So in order to collect as many of these crackable handshake packets as possible, Pwnagotchi uses two strategies. The first one is deauthenticating the client stations it detects. A deauthenticated device must reauthenticate to its access point by re-performing the four-way handshake with the access point, thereby giving Pwnagotchi another chance to sniff the handshake packets and collect more crackable material. The second strategy is sending association frames directly to the access point themselves to try to force them to leak the PMK ID. So now, when all the handshakes captured by your Pwnagotchi, they are saved into a pickup file on its file systems. Each pickup file that Pwnagotchi generates is organized according to access points. One pickup will contain all the handshakes that Pwnagotchi has ever captured from that particular access point. The next step is to understand what can be done with them. And this is where Hashcat comes into play. And Hashcat, for those of you who doesn't familiar with that, is a powerful tool used for recovering passwords from data we have obtained. But before we dive into it, it's crucial to remember that cracking Wi-Fi passwords should only be done on networks you own or have explicit permission to test. Ethical hacking is about learning and improving security, not exploiting vulnerabilities for unauthorized access. So don't forget. So returning to Hashcat, and Hashcat is an advanced password recovery utility that supports multiple platforms and algorithms. It's capable of utilizing the power of your CPU or GPU to crack passwords by matching them against a word list, also known as a dictionary attacks, or by trying all possible combinations known as brute force attacks. So let's talk about how it works with Wi-Fi handshakes. And the handshakes contains the encrypted form of the network password. And by using Hashcat, we attempt to decrypt this password by guessing it multiple times until we find a match. This process can vary in time from minutes to hours or even longer, depending on the complexity of the password and the power of your hardware. And on that, I think I spoke a lot before. If you missed one of my emails on passwords or weak passwords, please check the links in the description. Now, to use Hashcat, you will first need to prepare your capture handshake file and choose a word list. Word lists are dictionaries of possible passwords. There are many available online, some tailored to common passwords or theme around specific interests. And here is a simplified example of how you might use an Hashcat. So first, ensure your captured handshake file is in a format Hashcat can understand, such as .hccapx. Then you would run a command in Hashcat that looks something like this. And this tells Hashcat you are cracking a WPA2 handshake using a dictionary attack. And then Hashcat will then process the file against your word list, attempting to find the password. It's a game of patience and resources. The stronger and less common the password, the harder it is to crack. And this demonstrates the importance of using complex, unique passwords for securing networks. But again, remember, the goal here is not to promote unauthorized access, but to highlight the importance of strong security practices. And by understanding how passwords can be cracked, we can better secure our networks against potential threats. I just returned from a big cybersecurity event, and one of the speakers stated that adding salt or sugar to any dish can only improve it. AI is the same. Adding AI to any technology is improving it. And let's see the power of AI here. And one of the most important things is that Pwnagotchi is powered by AI. It uses AI model Actor Advantage Critic to teach itself and enforce hacking Wi-Fi networks. And the device makes funny faces that shows its mood. If Pwnagotchi says that it's bored, it must be fed immediately. To do this, we need to take the Pwnagotchi to a place where a lot of Wi-Fi networks are there to hack. The more practice it gets, the faster Pwnagotchi will crack new wireless networks. And Pwnagotchi has no controls and it's working automatically. All information about the operation of the device is displayed on the screen. the screen displays different information, as you can see it here. The screen also shows the special message when another person with a Pwnagotchi is nearby, and the virtual pet, as I mentioned before, can show different faces. So sleeping is the state unit will start from, awake, normal. This face is the natural awake status of the unit. Observing, the Pwnagotchi is watching and observing what better capture find on all the channels it's hopping on. Intense, unit is sending an association frame to an access point in order to force it to leak the PMK ID. Cool, the unit is authenticating a client station from an AP. And happy, your Pwnagotchi is happy for some reason, and so on. So to conclude, in today's video, we embarked on a captivating journey into the realm of Pwnagotchi, guiding our digital companion to feast on Wi-Fi handshakes and employing Hashcat to decipher these cryptographic bits. This process not only underscores the paramount importance of cybersecurity, but also emphasizes the ethical considerations within the realm of hacking. Now, by comprehending how vulnerabilities can be leveraged, we empower ourselves to fortify against potential threats. And Pwnagotchi serves as more than just a guide through the intricacies of the Wi-Fi security. It acts as a compass in an ever-changing landscape of cybersecurity threats. This dynamic educational tool underscores the significance of ethical hacking in safeguarding our digital domain. And as we wrap up, I encourage you to delve deeper into the world of Pwnagotchi and ethical hacking. Immerse yourself in the community, share your insight, and foster a culture of mutual learning. Remember, the ultimate objective is to enhance security for everyone. If you found value and acquired new knowledge, please show your support by liking, sharing with friends, and subscribing for additional content on cybersecurity, technology, and beyond. And always bear in mind, cybersecurity is an evolving field. Staying vigilant and informed constitutes our strongest defense against those who seek to exploit vulnerabilities. Let's collaborate, strive to create a safer digital landscape for all. Thank you for tuning in. Until our next encounter, keep hacking, but always with ethical integrity.